Blackboard Collaborate is a user-friendly online classroom. This clip provides a basic tutorial for initial setup and orientation for new users after they have logged in. This clip will guide viewers to initial setup of sound and video, orient viewers to audio, text, and symbol communication, orient viewers to online classroom etiquette, and it will orient viewers to slide function. In this section, I will be describing audio and video requirements. The majority of instruction and interaction is typically audio-based. It is essential to ensure your speakers or headphones are working. If at all possible, use headphones, as these reduce noise feedback looping back through your microphone. If you do decide to use speakers, ensure their volume is as low as possible to reduce the chance of noise feedback. You will need a microphone. Most tablets, phones, and laptops these days have inbuilt microphones. Desktop computers typically do not come with microphones. If you Skype, there is a good chance you do have a microphone. Microphones can be readily purchased, and I suggest if you need to, purchase it as part of a headset that comes already with a microphone. The audio setup is via the little icon with a microphone and red cog in the first third of your screen. Click on this and it will ask you to select the correct speakers. Press the select button and press OK. Now you can test your speakers by pressing play and adjusting the sound to the desired volume. When finished, press stop. The next screen will confirm if the speakers are at a comfortable listening level. If so, press yes. The next test is for the microphone. Select your microphone there. If there is no microphone showing, make sure you plug one in. Press OK and it will allow you to test your microphone volume and play it back again. When you have tested it, press stop and it will take you to another screen to listen to what you recorded. After pressing stop, it will show another screen to check your satisfaction. If you are satisfied, click yes. The next window will be a final message and you'll be ready to go. When you want to talk, press the talk button located here. The video is typically used only for an initial introduction as part of initially familiarizing people with the speaker and other participants. It is not typically used more as it tends to chew bandwidth and reduce the overall quality of the experience. To show your video, press video. To turn it off, press video again. There are a number of different ways of communicating in Blackboard Collaborate. The most common means of communication is verbal. As mentioned before, press the talk button and whatever you say in your microphone will be heard by the speaker and all other participants, with the exception of those in another virtual room. When you have finished talking, press talk again to mute your microphone. The chat window is where you can make comments that can be seen by everyone. People who do not have a microphone typically use this, however, it can also be used as a means of making comments while the speaker is talking without disrupting them. If you want to gain the speaker's attention that you have written something in the chat box, put your virtual hand up. I'll show you how to do this a little later on. Blackboard Collaborate has numerous functions. You can put your virtual hand up by pressing the hand icon. You will be ascribed a number so the presenter will know who had their hand up first. When the question or comment has been made, remember to press the hand again to put your hand down. Another feature is the communication icons. This allows you to communicate various messages such as applause, move faster or slower, and a number of others. This helps give the presenter feedback without having to type a longer message. Another feature is to step away from the session. If you have something to attend to outside of the session, you can step away and the presenter will know that you cannot be engaged while this is showing. The final one in the horizontal row is the Respond to Poll icon, which allows you to select yes or no to various questions that the presenter may pose. This way the presenter can see how many people voted yes and how many people voted no. There is also a vertical strip of icons too. These have a range of functions, but the one I'll show you is the text box. Here you can write on the whiteboard, which is particularly handy for small group work. Like any classroom, there are some basic rules that help maximize the entire class's ability to learn. The first is to raise your virtual hand when you want to speak, as one might do in a classroom. This helps prevent cross-talking and allows the presenter to decide when to invite you to speak. The second is to mute your microphone when not in use by ensuring the talk button on the screen is not active. Only press the talk button when you are going to talk to the group. Blackboard has limits on how many people can have the talk button pressed at any one time, so we want to ensure that everyone has a chance to talk if they choose to. Also, by leaving the talk button off when not using it, it means that you can make noise without disturbing the entire group. You will have noticed the slides on the screen. These slides are uploaded by the presenter or the host. You may either ask for a copy of the slides to be made available to you, or if the presenter records the session, the video of the session may be made available for participants to view at a later date, including the video of the slides. Congratulations for your willingness to learn about how to navigate Blackboard Collaborate's online classroom. I hope you really enjoy your session.